दंडावत बंदन अनक बार सर्वगला समरथ डोलन ते राख हो प्रभु नानक दे कर हाथ तेरे जोर मैं गुंगा कहता हूँ तेरा सदका तेरी शरण। तन साहिब श्री गुरु ग्रंथ साहिब जी दी गुरु खालसा साध संगत साहिब जीओ वाहिगुरु जी का खालसा वाहिगुरु जी की फतेह। टुडे इज़ द चेंज ऑफ द मंथ, टुडे इज़ द न्यू मंथ, द संग्रांद of Kartik. Sangrand is the change of the month, and just like in these Western countries, the majority of us go to the Gurdwara and do Sangat on a Sunday. In the old days, Gursikhs would come together on the start of a new month and take the teachings. And through Bara Maha, Guru Arjan Dev Sahib Ji, in the Maj Rag and in Tukhari Rag, Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji has given us all teachings that we take away for the rest of that month. And in Kartik, Guru Arjan Dev Sahib Ji start their teachings, Kartik karma kamavane dosh na kahu jog. So in this month of Kartik, the month of Kartik, in the Puranmashi, in the full moon of Kartik, that is the blessed month that Sahib Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji came to this earth. So it's a blessed month, Kartik is. The full moon of Kartik is when Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji, the form of God, first came to this earth so they can bless all humanity and we as Gursikhs. So Kartik karma kamavane, karma is the actions that we complete, kamavane is to complete those actions. Dosh na kahu jog, dosh is a blame, dosh karna, kisi te dosh karna, blame, na kahu jog. It's not worthy to blame anyone else for the actions that we complete in this month of Kartik. That is the teaching Guru Arjan Dev Sahib Ji has given us. So, in this blessed month, the month when Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji came to this world, if we forget Wahiguru, if we go astray, if we lose our love for Wahiguru and we complete those negative actions that are taking us away, why blame Wahiguru for leading us down? Sometimes we blame God and say, why did this happen to us? Why did that happen to us? Why should have this happened in my life? God, why didn't you bless me? You bless somebody else. And we blame Wahiguru. Sometimes we blame our families. Sometimes we blame our friends for leading us astray. But in this month of Kartik, we're being taught, dosh na kahu jog, don't blame no other apart from yourself. Whatever we do with our own hands. Ape bij, ape hi kahu. So whatever seed we sow, that is what we reap. That is the teaching of Gursikhi. Whatever action, whatever karma we do, that is what we have to face. So in karams, there are three types of karams, or they're categorized in three ways. Guru Gobind Singh Sahib Ji explained this to Bhai Daya Singh Ji Panj Pyare when they asked the question, Paralabdh, Kiryaman and Sanchit. So actions that we are doing are Kiryaman. If I'm about to do an action, I'm speaking, that is Kiryaman, actions that I'm doing. Sanchit is once I've done those actions. If I'm about to steal something, once I've stolen it, it's done. I can never change the past. Whatever I've done. That is called Sanchit. Sanchit means to collect. So those actions are then collected. They're written. We know and we've been taught that our account is always written, good and bad. Chitragupt comes in Gurbani, the names for those deities that write our good and bad actions and write our account. So those actions are written, and once we've done them, they become written and they are collected, Sanchit Karam. And then when we leave this world, all the actions that we've done in our previous lives, they're collected in a place, and when we're sent into the next life, they come as the form of Paralabdh. So they're called Paralabdh Karam, the Karam that we've come with from our previous lives. Paralabdh, what we've come with our previous lives. Kiryaman, the actions that I'm doing currently, and Sanchit, those that I do currently, they become collected and then they form the pot of karams where they're collected in Sanchit, and then the next round of Paralabdh takes you to your next place. And the Paralabdh decide how much food, our dana pani, the food that we're going to eat in the life, when we're going to leave this world, how we're going to die, the time we're going to die, the sama, the time, the place and how we're going to die is always written. The karam, the sanjog, vijog, doikar, chalave, likhe, ave, paag, the people we meet, we have sambandh with, our family, sanjog and vijog, the people we separate from, all that is decided due to our past actions. So it's our own actions that have brought us into this life. And the teaching of a Gursikhi is to bij nishkam actions, actions where we do prema bhakti and worship the Almighty Lord, so all our past actions can be burnt away. Each time we say Wahe, each time we meditate and affix ourselves on the Lord, all those past actions are being burnt away. And then the actions that we have to face in this life, the Paralabdh, they are becoming minute because we're blessed by our Guru who, even though they are Paralabdh and they've come with us, if they're negative, they'll make them from large to small. There are many Sakhiyas. when Guru Sahib Ji has reduced the actions that we were meant to face into a small set. So there are two Gursikhs. One does bad actions, one does good actions. One does satsangat and sings kirtan and goes in the sangat, and one does kukaram and goes to negative places and does wrongful acts. They meet together and they test each other out. And the sakhi is quite long, but when they test each other out, the person who does bad things arrives at the meeting point where they were going to meet under a tree. And as he's waiting for the person who's doing sangat, he digs in the ground and finds one gold coin. He digs further, but then he just finds some stones. And the person who's doing sangat, as he's coming back to that place, his foot is pricked by a thorn. And he questions that, you do good actions and you've been pricked by a thorn, I do bad actions and I still find a gold coin. They went to Guruji, and Guruji explained that the person who was doing bad actions in this life, in his previous life he do good actions and he donated a gold coin to a holy person, and he was meant to receive multiple gold coins, but he only received that one gold coin back because he's burnt his good actions and all the other ones were just those stones that he found. The person who is doing sangat in this life, he did bad actions in his previous life, but because he's doing sangat, he was meant to be hung and crucified, if you will, but because he's doing good actions, he'd only been pricked by a thorn. So good actions that we do in this life, doing sangat, repeating the name of the Lord, doing seva, even though we have to face those actions, they are reduced inside, so they are not as bad as one hopes. So Guruji still looks out and protects us, but if we do bad actions, har bisrat tere gun galea, all the good qualities, all the good actions that we've brought from our last life, they will be reduced. All our good will be reduced and we'll only have bad left, and we'll have to come and go in the 84 lakh joon. So we must remember that in this month of Kartik, that whatever action we do, whatever we sow, that is what we will reap and that is the benefit we will take. So let's not blame anybody. Let's accept the hukam of the Lord, whatever we live through. But for the future, let us repeat the name of the Lord. Let us do nishkam seva and our future will be beneficial in this world and in the afterworld. Let us hope and pray we can follow those teachings. Kattik karam kamavane dos na kahu jog. Don't blame anybody, just accept the hukam and live for the future by doing prema bhakti, true devotional worship. Deho sajjana si sidhiya, Jehovah sahib sume, lekha ka tehna shootiya, khin khin pulanhar, baksan har baksala, nanak par utar, Waheguru ji ka khalsa, Waheguru ji ki fateh.
Please like, comment, subscribe and share this video to spread the message of Sikhi. Make your dasvand safala and donate so we can create more content like this. The link is in the description below.